Make sure that the garbage is all the way down.
Yeah, I gotcha. I hear you. Hey, what's this? a little treasure trove. Check it out. Treasure trove.
Game at LA on Thursday night. The Yankees and Mets on cable vision. And of course, if the Islanders win here tonight, you will see game 7 right here, 8 o'clock from the Nassau Coliseum. The Rangers first to appear for period number 2.
Tim, this Saturday at 1 p.m., the CW Post Alumni Varsity Football game will be played at Hickox Field in Greenville. Looking ahead to this second period, I just have to reflect on the startling change that Coach Al Arbour made in the Islander lineup. He broke up his top line. He took Brian Trottier off the center ice position, and he put Lorne Henning there. He restored the line for the power play, and they scored the goal, the one goal of the game, which was scored by Mike Bossy from Trottier and Stefan Pearson. And Trottier had made an excellent play on Pearson's shot, deflecting it toward the left corner, but Davidson made a superb save on that one, but Bossy was Mike on the spot to get the rebound.
Behind the net, trying to center. It's blocked by Rush and rebounds out to Tinelli. Tinelli breaking with Henning. Into the Rangers zone. Henning the drive from the short side wide. Henning all the way around to Lewis on the rebound. Lewis's shot came all the way to Vadney for the Rangers. To Kachuk, checked by Hart. Hedberg trying to control. Henning steals. Henning with Harris. One man back. Henning in on goal. A shot saved by Davidson. Henning checked. Centering pass. Harris couldn't get the shot away. Another close call. Good effort by Lorne Henning. Kachuk into the Islander zone. Got by Potvin. Has been beaten twice in a row now. Hart off the glass. Knocks it down to the Ranger line. The team's changing on the go. Hart takes Sheehan out of the play. Here comes Hickey. Good play by John Tinelli. Back checking. Cleared to center ice. McEwen to Greshner. Greshner for the Rangers. The slap shot deflected by Potvin. Perfect timing. Goes way up into the end zone seats. We have 16-14 remaining here in the second period. The New York Islanders won. The New York Rangers nothing.
Tim, the Islanders putting on more pressure in this period. The Bossy line looking good with Lorne Henning centering Gillies and Bossy.
Mike Kosicki with between Gillies and Harris now as Al Arbour does another little juggling number. This is Ron Duguay. He can skate. He's taken into the corner by Hart. Kosicki's pass hit a skate. Kosicki gets it again. Kosicki leaving it for Hart. Hart to Potvin. Potvin back to Hart. This is a speedy forechecking unit when you have Duguay and Sheehan up front for the Rangers, and they've caused problems. Hickey keeps it in. Duguay into the slot, broken up by Harris. Harris passing to the open wing. There's nobody there. Sheehan picks it up. Sheehan circles right back. Fakes the shot, checked by Hart. Hickey to the blue line. McEwen to the corner. It rebounds to Resch near the goal mouth. Potvin for Harris. Met there. Harris behind his own net to Hart. This Ranger line has done the best forechecking for them through the game so far. They've caused fits in the Islander zone. Sheehan in the corner. Checked by Potvin. Hickey. Checked by Kosicki. Hickey trying to center. Potvin gets a piece. Kosicki finally clears it out. The best the Islanders can do. As Sheehan, Hickey, and Duguay have been doing an outstanding job pressuring the Islanders each time they've been on the ice.
At Boston Garden, the Islanders again being hemmed in, the defense having all kinds of trouble moving it out.
The Merrick line on now with Bourne and Nystrom against Esposito, Murdoch, and Don Maloney. They have just chased the two centermen. They're improperly facing off. It'll be Murdoch against Bourne, a pair of 14s. Islanders line up Merrick over on Esposito, who's playing on the right side for this draw. Murdoch won it back to Marois. The shot right on, save. Murdoch, the shot, score. John Murdoch. On a shot by Mario Marois. Lesch made the save through traffic, did not control the rebound. Murdoch was very patient. He pulled out to get a better shot and put it over Lesch.
Well, the faceoff was the problem there. Merrick tried to get the puck, but he couldn't quite get it. The shot was right on goal. Resch gave up a big rebound, and when it went to Murdoch, Resch went down, and he was actually took himself out of the play. He was almost turned around when the puck went by him. So the Rangers capitalizing on the Islanders' inability to move that puck out of their zone, and they tied the the score at one apiece. Don Murdoch, who was hurt earlier in the game, came back and he's played a strong game for the Rangers.
A happy Garden crowd acknowledging the tied-up game at 14:57 remaining second period. We'll see that goal once more. Some debris on the ice holding up play. A shot by Marois. And Resch could not control the rebound. Now, as he tries to play Murdoch, he lost his balance, it appeared, going over to the post. Murdoch was very patient. He had no... Born, Nystrom, Potvin, Hart. And Potvin slaps it to the boards, and Henning gets there to knock it past Marois. Down into the Ranger zone with 1:50 remaining in the penalty to Bob Lorimer. 1-1 the score. Islanders opened it, a power play goal by Bossy. Murdoch scored at 5:03 of the second. Tim Ryan with Stan Fischler at Madison Square Garden. Game 6, there is no tomorrow for the Rangers, for the Islanders if they lose this game tonight. The puck cleared down the ice by Jerry Hart. And it's Marois with 1:25 remaining in the penalty. Born forechecking. Problems for Marois. McEwen getting away from Henning, met by Born. McEwen to Marois. Left side, Don Maloney, chased by Hart. Esposito in the corner, looking for an open man. He's got Greschner. Born on him, back down to Esposito. Potvin's there. Esposito watched by Potvin. In the corner, Don Maloney, number 12, to the blue line. Greschner, screenshot, score! Don Maloney. Ron Greschner, I believe, got it all away. Maloney was there trying to tip it, but it looked like it went in clean. Well, credit to Greschner while we await the official score. 48 seconds remaining in Lorimer's penalty. 2-1 Rangers.
Well, the Rangers capitalized on their power play. They had control of the puck. The Islanders just couldn't get a piece of it. It went back to the point, and Ron Greschner, who's been sensational for the Rangers, put a hard one right on the corner. I don't think Resch had a chance on that. It caught the inside of the right post, so now the Islanders are up against it. They're behind for the first time in this hockey game as we approach the halfway mark of regulation time.
Ron Greschner does get credit